When I click this button, it's gonna do that for every single one of my tabs. Let's see. Now that is magical. We're going to be checking out a tool called GetMagical. It's a free Chrome extension that allows you to easily move information from one tab to another, replacing the need for the old Control-C, Control-V. No more copying and pasting. It promises to save salespeople time so they can get back to the other stuff that they should be doing, like, I don't know, selling? Let's go find out if GetMagical really is magical. Add to Chrome, it's free. Which tasks did GetMagical help you with? So it looks like there's three main use cases. The first one, messaging, bringing in information from other tabs into your emails or LinkedIn messages. Sourcing, filling spreadsheets, building lists. And data entry, updating your CRM. Looks like Salesforce and HubSpot at the bottom here. I'm gonna click all three. Let's go. You're a magician, Will.
I'm a what?
A wizard. And a thumping good one, I'd wager.
All right, so the first thing I'm gonna do is build a lead list. I'm gonna open up a Google Sheet. I've got one ready here. And I'm gonna basically bring in a bunch of information from LinkedIn to the sheet. So with the power of editing, I'm gonna open up 20 LinkedIn profiles in 3, 2, 1. And with that, I now have about 20 or so LinkedIn profiles open and ready to import into my lead list. I watched the video on the website, and I believe if I, first name Melissa, last name Cohen, head of corporate marketing, /location, Greater Boston, and then LinkedIn URL. So immediately that saved us a bunch of time because we didn't have to go back and keep switching to Melissa's tab and copying and then going back and pasting. So I get it. This is the part that looked pretty cool. So now if I do /, I get the option to transfer everything. And if I'm right in thinking, when I click this button, it's gonna do that for every single one of my tabs. Let's see. There we go. Now that is magical. That's pretty cool. Let's see what else we can do. If I'm right in thinking, it's not just LinkedIn that you can pull information from. You can do it on Yelp and Yellow Pages. So let's give that a go real quick. So here's a list of cheap dinner restaurants in downtown Halifax. So I can start opening them up. And then I've got a bunch of variables that it's automatically picked up on this website, repeating variables like the name of the restaurant, the address, the price range, and those types of things. But let's say I also wanna do opening hours. So I can select this one here, and I can select this one, and I can do opening hours. So I'll label that, and then we do /, company name, Dirty Nelly's, Sackville Street, boom, like that. And now because I've got three other restaurants open, I can do that again, transfer everything. And again, I've built another list of something. Yeah, this is gonna save you a ton of time if you're someone who's building lists or often copying and pasting information between browser tabs. But what else can we use this for? Let's take a look. Let's say we wanna update our CRM. I go to HubSpot.com. So I create new contact, come in here, /, and then I can grab like Luis, and then do /, Ribeiro, job title, and then create. When I go back and create a new contact again, I can go create contact, /, Jonathan. And this time around, it automatically does all that for me, so I'd have to keep repeating the same task over and over. Again, massive time saver here. One thing I did just notice is this. In the platform, you can create shortcuts. So let's say I want to create a shortcut here. I can call this Calendly. To save me going back and forth and always having to copy and paste my Calendly link into my emails, I can just copy that link and then throw it in here, save that, and then whenever I want to use my Calendly link, I can just do /, Calendly, and click. And it brings my link in automatically. No need for me to go find it and copy and paste it into the email. Now, one of the big use cases they had on the website was messaging. And I understand this could be for an email or a LinkedIn message. So what you're able to do is create templates, find them. So in this case, outbound email first touch is an email template that I just created. Click on that. If I'm right, then I believe all I need to do now is go Luis, company name, gong, and job title. Boom. And then insert. And automatically I've now put Luis's details into the email. It looks like this will also work if I go find someone who I'm not connected to, like Patricia, it's my grandma's name, add a note in here, /, LinkedIn connect, and then it automatically fills in Patricia's name into this connection request, so we can insert that, shoot off to Patricia, saved a bunch of time writing out a note. Let's take a quick look at pricing. Okay, while GetMagical has been a free product to date, we intend to introduce paid plans in the future for premium features. So it's free. Sweet. Okay.
We'll take the lot.
This is, to me, one of those ones that just makes sense. Even if I was just using the keyboard shortcuts, for example, // Calendly to insert my booking link, I would be saving a ton of time with this. At this point, I'd normally do some pros and cons. I don't have any cons that come to mind for this tool. I think some of this functionality may be covered off by other tools that you might be using. For example, if you're using a sales engagement platform like Outreach or SalesLoft, a lot of those merge tags are probably done for you, but those are pretty expensive tools and this is free. So if you're not using one of those, then yeah, this would save you a lot of time customizing emails, bringing in customer details, updating your CRM, building lead lists. So in my opinion, Magical is magical. As always with these videos, I've linked the tool below, so if you want to try it out, go check that out. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Are there any tools that you would like to see me try in the future? Please, I'm running out of ideas. If not though, then just drop a like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time on Sales Tech Talks.